Just do your thing, though. Do your thing and leave everybody else alone. Let them, unless it's hurting you, then you can stop them, right? Other than that, just leave them alone. How many smokers are here on applause if you smoke cigarettes? Let me hear you. Smokes or smokers, yeah. There's many religious people as smokers. Awesome. Non-smokers, if you do not smoke cigarettes, let me hear you. Non-smokers, come on, there. Yeah. Yes. I'm a smoker. That's for you. Screw all you people. There's my cigarette finger for you. No, because you guys are jerks about it. You didn't do the right thing and go after the manufacturers of the cigarettes. You just outlawed them, basically, to smoke them anywhere. You can buy them anywhere you want. They're like rocks on the ground, but good luck finding a place to smoke them. That's where we're at now. It's really frustrating. I don't blow smoke in people's face. I'm not a jerk about it, but you guys are like, it's awful. First, it was like the restaurants you couldn't smoke in, and as a smoker, I'm like, I'm all right with that. Then it was the bars. I'm like, really? Now there's eight of us hunched over in a field. Just... What's wrong, Bob? They put a roof over the city, they're serving wings. This is bull crap. We're angry. Very upset about it. Can't smoke anywhere, sir. Nowhere. I travel. I gotta go to airports and stuff. I can't smoke in the airports anymore. It's ridiculous. There's no smoking lounges in the airport. They took them all out. Well, there is one airport that still has a smoking lounge. Anybody know what it is? Tampa has one? After the show, tell me, because I don't know where it's at. never seen that, ma'am, apparently. Atlanta has a really big smoking lounge. Yeah. Here's the thing. It's like smoker's punishment. It's not in a lounge at all. It's on the main concourse. It's a big plexiglass wall. So the smokers are inside on display for all the non-smokers as they walk by. It's bullcrap. And you're sitting there just trying to do your legal goddamn thing, right? And people walk by. I've actually had people, I had a woman walk by and see me in there and go like this and go, Cindy, look at him in there. Look at him in there. Here's the weird thing. If there's enough smokers in there, you can't even see them. That's the crazy part. It's like a smoker's aquarium. It just fills up with smoke, and if you stand in front of it long enough, you might catch a glimpse of the smoker. If it comes off the glass, then back into the mist. What the hell was that? That was a puffer fish. You see him? A puffer fish. He was there a second ago. Gotta use a lounge. Otherwise, you gotta go outside. You have to leave the airport and go outside. And here's the thing now, they take your fire from you. Do you know that, sir? Take your fire. You're a guy, you should have fire and a penis. Fire, penis, they should have those two things. With those two things, you can get pretty much anything else you want. Fire, penis. Okay, maybe not you, I can't. But anyway. You seem confused on one of those two things. I don't know which one it was. Penis? What is this penis you speak of? They take your fire. Anyone know why they take the fire? Because of the shoe bomber terrorist guy. Remember that dude? The shoe, the guy that had a bomb in his shoe. Look, I'm not here to make fun of terrorism, they're a serious thing, but if you're gonna be a terrorist and have a bomb, pick one that somebody can't blow out. How about you start there, right? Imagine that guy in a plane, I'm going to blow up the plane, he goes, like that, and somebody goes, really, dude? Oh, you asshole, I'm serious, I do it again, I'm not kidding around right now. Light that again. And because of that guy, I had to leave the airport and go into the parking lot and pick up a rock and like approach strangers. Like, I just want to have a cigarette. I'm going to strike this off. I swear to God, I'm not gay. Just one strike off the zipper. I won't look at your penis, I swear to God. And then you got to go in and out of that stupid x-ray crap, all that stuff. I hate that, the x-ray thing. Last time I was in the airport, the guy at the x-ray machine literally fell asleep. Could you believe that? Homeland Security, he's asleep. I was shocked. And I'm a comedian, and I'm not too bright. So I just went, that dude jumped up with his shoe, like, what the hell was that? I don't even know how he got it off. I didn't even see it happen. It was very funny. The cavity search afterwards was really not that funny. That was very uncomfortable, and the guy never called me back. So it was a wash.